I really came at this as a physician and an engineer and an inventor. I had to learn how to start companies because I could see for our inventions that the work wasn't done and I really needed to get out there. I've done it 8 times now, and what I realized once I sort of got behind the curtain was that many of my women peers were not by my side, but there was no good reason for it. So the Faculty Founder Initiative started when Susan Hockfield, Nancy Hopkins, and I calculated that if over this last 18 years, women faculty had been starting companies in biotech at the same rate as the men in their departments, there would be 40 more companies. And you just imagine that if every entrepreneurial university is missing that many companies, how many medicines, how many cures are missing around the world? So we started the Faculty Founder Initiative. We've been doing experiments to hack the problem. This prize competition is one such experiment, and it was the brainchild of Anantha Chandrakesan, who is our Dean of Engineering and Chief Innovation Officer.
We asked them to do a lot, succeed in their roles as faculty, join the entrepreneurship model that's so deeply embedded in MIT's identity and purpose, and each of them must also meet the great demands from their families and communities.
They take an entrepreneurship boot camp that Bill Ouellette teaches at the Sloan School.
To run in the race.
We have a class where MBA students can actually partner with them and work on the business plan.
To be able to work with all of these faculty founders.
In this cycle, we collaborated with Brown University. We have 12 women coming through.
And today is a showcase where you get to meet all of them in rapid fire.
So instead of exclusively focusing on treating the body when we want to treat pain, what we need to do is we need to start to focus on the brain as well.
This is, in fact, a miniaturized human heart tissue in order to develop tomorrow's drugs for cardiac patients.
This is the state of an aggressive brain cancer called glioblastoma. This is a death sentence.
Force Bio is developing a high-throughput platform for screening engineered muscle tissues in vitro.
And our real goal is to bring nanoformulations that are rationally designed and cell-selective to the clinic.
We've developed a new neurofeedback technology that can actively drive the flow of CSF in the brain while we sleep.
But there are a lot of cancer types that have been left behind. For example, these solid tumors that have dismal survival rates.
To enable a pipeline of drugs for applications in oncology and immunology.
RNA therapeutics to treat cancer patients who do not respond to existing immunotherapies.
So better batteries can enable exciting new growth trajectories and unprecedented device functionalities.
If you would like to learn more about how to use brain simulations to unlock the power of neurotherapies, please come talk to us.
You've put in the time. You're going to make a difference with this startup and with future startups. And we're so honored that you have been a part of this cohort. So thank you.
We were really fortunate this cycle to have the sponsorship and support of Royalty Pharma.
I think that in this kind of golden age of biotech and golden age of discovery, we can innovate further and really help society by having more companies founded by women.
To me, changing the game means that when you have an idea and you have an invention in your lab, that you're connected enough to the ecosystem to know when it should be a company. And you know who to call, and you know how to get your first investors, and you know quickly how to catalyze your team, and you're off to the races. And every one of those inventions can be a medicine as quickly as possible. That's the future, I imagine.